Oh, this is cool.
Hey, hello. Are those seats taken?
Thank Minister Teo for coming and traveling here. Josephine and I have developed a very close working relationship over the past year, and it's really a pleasure for me to have you here. Singapore has brought their largest delegation ever to Select USA with 28 companies, and I want to thank you for that. I would like to acknowledge Ambassador Kaplan, who is here in the audience. Last June, I launched the Select Global Women in Tech Mentorship Network. It was a virtual event last year, of course, but we launched this mentorship network, and more than 70 female founders from 30 different markets participated in that event a year ago. Since that time, this initiative has flourished. Having been a woman in the tech industry and as a tech investor before getting into public office, I experienced personally the value of mentorship, which is why it's so important for me to start this initiative. It is, you know, sometimes you need to know what questions to ask, you need to know who to call, you need to know the right way to pitch your company, and mentorship and often women are left out of those informal discussions and networks. So that's exactly why we started this mentorship network, and I'm committed to ensuring that it expands. Last November, I traveled to Singapore and had the opportunity to be with Minister Teo, and she and I co-hosted at that time a roundtable discussion assisting female tech entrepreneurs in seizing opportunities in the digital economy. I had the opportunity to host and hear from women entrepreneurs in Singapore in the digital tech space, and it was fantastic. I can speak for both of us, I think. It was energizing, and Josephine is a leader in this area. Today, I'm announcing that we're going to take these events one step further through the U.S. Singapore Partnership for Growth and Innovation, the PGI. Minister Teo and I now are excited to announce the U.S. Singapore Women in Tech Partnership Program. Through the Select Global Women in Tech Program, U.S. mentors will support female Singaporean entrepreneurs who want to succeed in the United States. And I think we have two right here on the stage with us that we're going to hear from in a bit. Select USA will be hosting a series of events in the coming months, and we look forward to participation from Singaporean companies. Under the program, Singaporean mentors will also support U.S. entrepreneurs looking to get exposed to the Singaporean tech ecosystem. So So this, I'm really excited for this. It'll bring our countries closer together, our entrepreneurial communities closer together, and help women in the tech industry in Singapore and in the U.S. So it's a huge initiative building on our past work, and I couldn't be more excited. So with that, I'd like to turn it over to Minister Teo.
Thank you very much. Let me say how much of a pleasure it is for me to be here today and to share the stage with Secretary Raimondo, together with outstanding leaders in our tech scene in Singapore. Let me just add to Secretary Raimondo's points by adding three of my own. The first is that when you think about the economic links between the U.S. and Singapore, they are really broad and deep. And as a reflection of that, when you look at trade, there is a very large volume exceeding essentially $150 billion every year. And with the U.S. enjoying a very healthy trade surplus of about $10 billion in more recent years. And when we look at investments in the USA, Asians investors, Singapore would be the second largest, behind only Japan. And so when we put these two together, US exports to Singapore, as well as Singapore investments in the US, together support something like 250,000 American jobs, quarter of a million. And like Secretary Raimondo mentioned, we've agreed to take this very close economic links even further through the establishment of the Partnership for Growth and Innovation in October last year. And that brings me to the second point. And that is, when we think about Singapore, it is useful to remember us as a gateway to Southeast Asia, which is a region of about 650 million people with a fast-growing middle class. And one particular exciting potential, area of potential, is in the digital economy. And according to some estimates, 1 in 5 Bain, together with our own sovereign wealth fund, Temasek Group, they think that between 2022 and 2025, in those 4 years, the digital economy in Southeast Asia will double to around $360 billion. And that perhaps explains why so many unicorns are being born in our part of the world. In the last few years, of the 35 unicorns that have been definitely emerged, just under half of them actually were raised in Singapore. So as a gateway to Southeast Asia, there certainly is a lot that Singapore is happy and would like to do for our partners around the world. And the third point is that Secretary Raimondo and I have discussed that it is really important for us to ensure that women have a voice in the action. Not only because it is, it is right that we create more opportunities for women, but also because women have so much to bring to the table. Later on in our discussion, you will hear from you as well as humans about the exciting kinds of work that to expand their global footprint, starting with investments in the U.S. perhaps. But equally, I believe, and that's the third point I want to make, is that our women in tech can be a bridge for international businesses to expand their footprint in Southeast Asia. We are fortunate that in Singapore, women as a share of the tech workforce, we're not doing too bad. Against the global average of 28%, it is 41% in Singapore. We'd like to grow it further. And there are no better examples than the women who are participating in the U.S. Singapore Women in Tech Partnership Program. So I'm equally excited about the prospects for us to deepen our ties and to create more opportunities for women in tech to succeed. Thank you.
And Secretary.